interesting game for Russell Wilson, who didn't start off particularly well. Just 12 yards passing in the first quarter. He was actually booed at home before the break, but he certainly made plays for his team down the stretch, and he wasn't the only one. Rod Woodson, Maurice Jones-Drew, those running backs for Seattle, Penny, running Carson, backs. Davis, combined for 155 yards on the ground. How big was that balance for them in this one?
Well, you know, the first couple weeks for the Seahawks, week one and two, they were trying to lean on Russell Wilson, trying to get him to throw the ball. And, you know, that worked last year and the year before, but they really didn't go to the playoffs. So they had these three backs. They decided after week three, let's start running the ball a little bit and get going. And they've been rushing like crazy. I remember calling the game in Seattle against the Rams where they rushed for almost 190 yards. And so when you can lean on your running game, you can get your offensive line to go forward. You can protect Russell Wilson, limit his throws, limit his ability to get hit, help your offensive line out. And the play-action pass comes in huge. And we saw that in this game. That's how they've been getting their chunk plays. Play-action pass to Tyler Lockett down the field, and then also letting these running backs go forward. You got three of them.
Ron, you picked the Packers to win this game.
Uh-oh.
What happened that you weren't expecting?
Well, allowing the run, first of all. I mean, I didn't think they were going to gash him that bad. But, you know, really thinking, like, when you look at – Aaron Rodgers, he played tremendous first half. Didn't play that well in the second half. The team didn't play that well in the second half. But that third down play that he had, a third and two play, where he threw the ball in the dirt, that's not like Aaron Rodgers. This is not Aaron Rodgers-esque where he throws the ball in the dirt. And I know he said the ball stuck in his hands, whatever that meant. But I don't really have a problem with Aaron Rodgers, but I do have a problem with Mike McCarthy not going for it on fourth down. Because what he told the whole world is that, you know what, I trust my defense more than I trust Aaron Rodgers. I don't know if that's the case. You should, anytime Aaron Rodgers fourth and two, you got one timeout, 3 minutes, something left on the clock. They haven't stopped in the whole second half. You let Aaron Rodgers at least try to make a play.
How many games this year has he not gotten the ball back when it seemed like there was going to be plenty of time for him to do that?
Quite a bit. Yeah. Head scratchers.
Right? Packers are technically still in the playoff mix. They're the 8th seed right now in the NFC, but they are third in the NFC North. I said technically. They are two games back of the Bears in that division. Is there still hope? It doesn't sound like he thinks, though. Let's see what Aaron Rodgers thinks.
Aaron, is there any hope left for this season?
Come on, Rod. What kind of question is that?
I don't know. I mean, it doesn't. Come on, man. Can't win on the road. What are you going to be able to do?
I don't even know how to answer that, Rob. I mean, come on, what am I supposed to say? Of course there's hope. Of course we believe in each other. You know, we're just going to take one galvanizing moment. So whether that's a speech or a practice or something happens in the game, something's got to get this thing going. I mean, nobody gave up hope. You know, we just didn't play well enough when we had to play well enough.
One galvanizing moment. I think that's the song they play at the end of the NCAA tournament. No. Okay, no, they've got six games left to find that moment that he's looking for, and might not have Jimmy Graham. He broke his thumb last night. Found out this morning. Is it time to get out of Fork? What do we think?
You know what? Let me take this walk and help them out a little bit.
Oh, you're going to, okay.
Can I go help him out? Is that cool?
See what you got for him.
All right, let me make sure I got all my stuff with me as I go. Rod, like hold on, Puma. I'm going to get that in a second. James, are you watching? Is James Jones watching? Do we all know this? Is James watching?
Don't rub it in James like anywhere? That. That's not
all
cool.
All right, here we go. It's all right. Listen, the Packers on the road, 0-for. So they're going to continue that here going to Minnesota. It's a tough thing going into that dome, and the loud noise, all that kind of stuff. I have them getting the victory versus the Cardinals. I have them beating the Falcons. The Falcons don't play well outside. It's cold, Cole. You know that. Cold world. You know how it is. Chicago. They're playing well right now, so that's an L. They get their first road win against the Jets, then they win here. And that's not going to get it done. So, JJ, Thanksgiving has come early. It's time to stick a fork in it, my friend.
Why you got to make that all personal? Like, James is out there,
that's
you know.
That's my dog. I mean, James knows what time it is. Did you like that?
I like the fork. That's a big fork.
I love Aaron Rodgers,
though. Where do you find
though?
a fork like that?
Do you eat with that fork?
I can. You know, it just depends on how big the turkey is. No, cereal, it would be, you know, I only do cereal with water. I'm lactose intolerant. But James came on this set, a couple weeks ago, talking big trash. I love Aaron Rodgers. I just think right now they're not playing well as a team.
They are not.
And we want to be confident and believe in Aaron Rodgers, but you need all 22 to do those. Actually, all 33, special teams as well.
I can believe in Aaron Rodgers and not as much the people around him.
I'm about to roll off. There we go.
for perspective, for that 8-7-1 record, the Bears could get to 7 wins this week if they beat the Vikings. That is the primetime game on Sunday.
Stick a fork in them.
More on that game coming.
They're done.
Up.